it's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. The regular crowd shuffles in as an old man sitting next to me, making love to his tonic and gin.
We'll be right back.
search for tenderness, it isn't hard to find. You can have the love you need to live. And if you look for truthfulness, you might just as well be blind. It always seems to be so hard to give. Honesty, such a lonely word. Everyone is so untrue. Honesty is hardly ever heard. Say that sacrifice. If I wear my heart out on my sleeve, but I don't want some pretty face to tell me pretty lies. All I want is someone.
Still rockin' old me. Yeah. looks and a whole lot of money. The next day's new way, that's great. Better ways to still rock and roll to me. Everybody's talking about the new sound, but it's still rock and roll to me.
Do 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 do.
two, one, two, three, four.
Whoa. She only reveals what she wants you to see. She hides like a child, but she's always a woman to me. She can lead you to love, she can take you or leave you. She can ask for the truth, but she never believes you. And she'll take what you give her as long as it's free. She's still
feels like a thief, but she's always a woman to me. Promise you more than the Garden of Eden. She'll carelessly cut you and laugh while you're bleeding. But she'll bring out the best and the worst you can be. Blame it all on yourself, 'cause she's always a woman to me.
Yeah. See you in London. London, England, all right.
Try and please me. You never let me down before. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. We never could have come this far. I took the good times, take the bad times, take you just the way you are. Don't go trying some new fashion, and don't change the color of your hair. You always have my
and passion. Although I might not seem to care, never want to work that hard. I just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are. Need to know that you will always be the same old someone that I knew. But will it take till you believe in me, way that I believe in you? I said I love you, that's forever, and this I promise from the heart. Could not love you any better. Love you just the way you are. Just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are. Oh, 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 oh.
This is my 50th year as a professional musician. In 1964, Beatles came out, and then there was a band everywhere. And on every block, there was a band.
The Moment Like Yours.
No, it's before the Hassle. We love the Lost Souls. Anyway, this is the Downer Still Loves.
Took off these little like a lot of go away, you go into the rest of the people that you knew, you go into the rest of their lives. They take them with you. So, but also this was during a time when her mom and I were splitting up. So this was like a double-pronged thing, like, Daddy, are you gonna leave me? And I said, I'll never leave you. I will never leave you. I'll never go away. I will never, never, ever leave you. So it was a tough answer, you know, in both respects. So I'm trying to remember when I was writing on. I'm gonna finish something I didn't finish before. Just a little more piano, dear.
Thank you. Good night, thank you.
Much more fun, darling. You know only the good die young.
Then I'm moving. to provide communication constantly. When you love someone, you're always insecure. And it's only when the way reassure. She can't be with you. Tell her you wish you were there. Tell her about it every day before you leave. Pay her some attention. Give her something to believe. Though you may not have done anything, will that be a consolation when she's gone? Listen, boy, it's good information from a man who's made mistakes. It's the world that it makes. She's a trusting soul. She's put her trust in you. But a girl like that won't tell you what to do. Tell her about it. Then know how much she cares. Give her every reason to accept that you're real. Tell her about it. Tell her all your crazy griefs. Let her know that you need her. Let her know how much she.
Here in Allentown, and it's hot. Everything I'm feeling older and I'm missing my younger days. Oh, then you should have known me much better, cause the past is something that never got in my way. Oh, no. Still, I would not be here now if I never had the hunger. And I'm not ashamed to say the wild boys were my friends. Oh, cause I never felt the desire. The music set me on fire, and then I was saved. Yeah. That's why I'm keeping the faith. Yeah, 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 keeping the faith. The old matador beats only flat brothers, had him with the Cuban heel. Iridescent socks with the same color shirt and a tight pair of chinos. Oh, I put on my sharkskin jacket, you know, the kind with the velvet collar, did it by shades. Oh, yeah. Took a fresh pack of Lucky's and a mint called Sensen. My old man's Trojans and his old Spice Abiché. Oh, I comb my hair in a pompadour, like the rest of the Romeos wore.
It all depends upon your appetite. meet you anytime you want in our Italian restaurant.
you anytime you want in our Italian restaurant.
Thank you. Shelters on the ground till the Soviets turn. that song about is here tonight. Right over here, Victor. Just came from Russia. Rostovia. Thank you. It's good to see you, Victor. This next song is...
Every once in a while we get a request to do a song off an album that you can't play anywhere. You can very hard to find it. This is off an album called Cold Spring Harbor. I like the songs, but the record was kind of speeded up, and it made my voice sound like a chipmunk on it. So when they speed up a record, your voice comes out high. You know, like you sing like this, and your voice comes out like that. You know. So anyway, this is a song called She's Got Away.
Let's go. Come down to reality, and it's fine with me. 'cause I'm in them. I'm in a New saxophone from Brooklyn, New York. It's Mark Rivera.
Well, boy, got dark in a hurry, didn't it? You see, in just a couple of minutes, you see how dark it got, Paul?
Yeah.
That's unbelievable to me. Earlier, the sun was setting, and now look at that, it's pitch black.
How does that happen?
I don't know. I have to call Al Roker again.
Well,
our next guest is one of the most successful singer-songwriters in popular music, having sold over 90 million albums. His brand new CD, Greatest Hits, Volume 3, will be in stores tomorrow. Here he is, Billy Joel. Billy! We'll be right back.
make your dreams come true.
Mr. Joel. Goodbye. Nice going. Thank you very much. Tell the folks who's playing organ and singing during the commercial there.
That's on the Hammond organ. That's Mr. Felix Cavalier from the Rascals.
Yes. Felix, welcome back to the show.
Thank you
for being on the show. You've been very nice to us, very generous, very friendly with your time over the years for us here in New York City. And the song that you sang is a Bob Dylan song?
It's a song written by Bob Dylan, which wasn't on a Bob Dylan album. And I'm putting out a greatest hits album tomorrow, and they like to have new songs for radio to play. And I really haven't been writing rock and roll songs. I've been writing classical music, so.
Classical music?
Yeah.
And why is it? You have enough money? I guess so.
I guess I do, actually. But it's something I've always enjoyed. There are songs I've written, actually, that are like classical music. And the president of the record company said, there's this great song by Bob Dylan that isn't on an album. And I heard it, and my hair stood up on my arms when I heard
it. It's a beautiful song. You must know Bob Dylan. I would guess that you guys are friends or have certainly met each other.
I've met Bob over the years from time to time. First time I met him, he came to visit me. His daughter, it turns out, was a fan of mine. This is back in the early 80s. He comes over my apartment. I was living at the San Moritz Hotel. I had this great apartment at San Moritz. And introduces his daughter to me, and she's a fan, and she's asking me all these questions. And I'm trying to carry on a meaningful conversation with this, you know, teenage girl, and in my kitchen is Bob Dylan, you know? And he's leaning against my refrigerator going, hey, it's okay, you know? It's cool. And I thought it was, you know, he was a good dad. He was being a good dad. Yeah. I thought that was nice.
That's a nice thing for both of you to have done, and a great thing for the kid as well.
Yeah.
And did you, was there ever anything you got from him that you thought, well, this is insight, this is unusual to our profession, I'm going to hang on to something that he has told you or said to you?
I asked him at one time, I met him at a gig, believe it or not, in Milan, Italy. They have these funny venues over there. They don't have hockey arenas and basketball arenas and Madison Square Gardens. They have like Bicyclone Tron.
Oh, like velodrome.
Velodrome, yeah. Velcro things. And very strange gigs. And you go backstage, and Bob was backstage in Milan, and I go, and he goes, hey, Billy, how you doing? He said, what are you doing in Milan? I said, well, I'm here to see you, man. And I always wanted to ask him, because I'm now building up a large catalog of songs, and I start worrying if I'm going to forget words. And Bob's written more words than there are. And I said, how do you remember all these words? Oh, that's easy. Just go over in the dressing room and take a look on the coffee table.
And this is, you sound like Bob Dylan if he had a cartoon show.
He was in a good mood that night, I guess.
Yeah.
So I look over on the coffee table, and there is like a store-bought book, Bob Dylan's The Songs of Bob Dylan.
He's got them all right there.
He's got this big book on the coffee table, and I said, well, okay, but how do you read the lyrics on stage? He goes, well, I really can't read them. I just feel good knowing they're there.
Casey has to run backstage and do some research on his own material.
It's like a security blanket, and I've actually started doing that. I put a little book of lyrics on the piano. Of course, you can't dive into them in the middle of a song. But
it just makes you feel a little bit better.
There they are. Yeah.
Now, talking about money, you now, in addition to everything else, are building boats, designing boats. What is the...
I like boats. It's my great getaway. I can go 100 yards offshore, and it's like I'm on another planet. Mm-hmm. It really is a great way for me to get away. And I've had a couple of boats built. And this was a boat that I helped to design based on the old commuter boats from the
30s and 40s. It's a good-looking boat, isn't it?
It's a handsome boat.
Yeah, it's a lovely piece of work. And is this an old, like an old wooden boat, or is this steel?
It's actually made out of fiberglass with a Kevlar, infused Kevlar, and it's very strong. And it looks like an old boat, but it goes about 60 miles an hour. So you're going along on this boat, and these guys are going by, and they're, you know, they're fast boats, and they're production boats, and they see this old boat coming up to them, and they go, ha, 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 and they put the throttle down, and you just keep going ahead of them. and then they get on the horn after a while, and they go, what the hell is that thing, you know? And it's a Shelter Island runabout. So,
and you have your own boat building company.
Well, I'm the guy who owns the parts that they make the mold from, the hull and the fiberglass
That's very cabin. Impressive. And you own one of these yourself, obviously?
Yeah, but I never get to use it because my boat is the demo boat, so they're always showing customers.
Salesman always out in your boat.
Exactly.
How many have you sold?
Well, it's a small production. We've sold about six boats now. They can only knock out about six boats a year. It's a small place on Shelter Island.
Hand-built kind of thing?
Yeah, they're really done by handcrafted, workers.
Well, that's great. I'm very, very impressed by that. And if a person like me, not just a guy off the street, but if a person like me wanted to buy one of these boats, how much, how bad would I get hurt?
Well, we know you have the cake, Dave. So. I'll put in a good word for you, though.
Thank you very much. The CD, it will be in stores tomorrow. Greatest Hits, volume number 3. And this would, I guess, take you closer to 100 million in sales, wouldn't it? Something like that?
Hopefully.
Yeah, good for you. Thank you again, Billy.
Thank
nice
you,
to see you. Billy Joel, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back here.
Xưa